this building here is going to give us the venue from which to both engage those students, build that community, give them a sense of values that will help shape society for the better, and then be able to carry that forward into the world.
I am Jesse Grizzle, director of the Michigan Robotics Institute, and I'm standing right in front of our Ford Motor Company Robotics building. This building is going to allow us to bring all of the roboticists on campus together. In addition, we have Ford Motor Company on the fourth floor.
I think the facilities themselves are unique in that there's so many different labs that allow walking, running, flying, jumping, rehabilitation, bays for full-size cars. All of that put together allows somebody like me, who's normally in aerospace, to see cutting-edge self-driving car technology.
So the Michigan Robotics Building has robotics education in mind. We have dedicated facilities for our robotic systems laboratory course at the graduate level. We have undergraduate lab facilities to facilitate both first-year courses and also upper-level courses so that students can be inspired from the first day that they walk on campus all the way through their entire experience.
Our co-location really allows us to bring a very diverse workforce from both sides together, and we can work on joint projects, both academic and production-oriented, that just make something special.
I think robots in the future are going to be systems that integrate advanced computer science, the AI, the networking, the databases, the edge and cloud computing resources, with the mechanical devices in a holistic system that is working with people. It's not replacing people, it's working with people. And I think in the future, we're gonna get a society, not just in this building, but outside this building, that appreciate the value of having these robotic devices every day in our lives.
I think we have the chance to become the number one group in the nation in this area, and we will set milestones for research, collaboration, climate, and education.